A very good afternoon, everyone. Today, I want to highlight the psychology of terrorists through various psychological examinations with the help of case studies. So, it is the universal truth that terrorism undeniably constitutes a vital challenge for the nation. The main targets of these terrorist groups are tourist spots, pilgrimage places, hotels, railway stations, market, sporting venues, where they can kill a lot of people and can create future panic. They identify the loopholes in the security system before targeting them, thereby increasing civilian casualties and maximize the impact and publicity. The terrorists also shift their targeting patterns from civilians to government and military targets to spread intimidation and create a permanent state of fear. Now the brief description of cases. The subjects brought in the laboratory were those terrorists who were directly and indirectly involved in various attacks committed in India. All of them were of the age group of 25 to 40 years. Some of them were the prime suspects in carrying out attacks, and others were involved in reconnaissance around and surveillance of the potential targets. They were brought with a request to probe the critical issues linked with the terrorist activities transpired at various places in India. To get the fruitful results, various psychological tests were conducted on those subjects, which included forensic psychological assessment. In forensic psychological assessment, the subject's verbal and non-verbal behavior, cognitive ability, appearance, emotional mood, speech and thought patterns are noted carefully during the course of interview. The interview focused on the major terrorist traits, tendency including the aggressive behavior, state of mind behind the violence. The mental status examination of the subjects revealed that there was no observable symptoms of any neurotic or psychotic disorder. Rather than they were characterized by deep-rooted inferiority complex, negative self-concepts, frustration and suppressed aggression. Their perception of weapons as fetish as and adherence to violence, subcultural norms. They were all pessimistic towards their life and highly sensitive towards their religion and jihad. Some of them were found to be calm and relaxed as they have completed their mission. There was no regret feeling on their face. These traits make up an authoritarian extremist personality. The second test was draw a person test. The basic aim of draw a person test is to evaluate the various psychological states, especially assessing emotional disturbances, aggressiveness, social conflicts, personality traits of the individual. The personality of the subjects can be depicted from their drawings. As you see in the pictures, the poor disintegration of all body parts indicate that they are emotionally disturbed, and aggression, which can be observed in all the body parts of the drawing. As the shape of the drawing is very disturbed, it shows that they are having aggressive tendencies, extreme tension, rigid thinking, and they are having feeling of weakness and intellectual inferiority. Next test was polygraph examination. The polygraph test works by measuring the physiological changes in the body when the individual being tested is asked certain questions. The polygraph instrument measures changes in the heart rate, blood pressure, respiratory rate, and sweat. And the changes to the individual's normal rate can indicate that the subject is attempting to be deceptive. During the interrogation, these terrorists denied any contact with any of the terrorist group and their involvement in the terrorist activities. During polygraph examination, the relevant issues were probed. Significant changes which occur during the questioning, such as faster heart rate, high blood pressure, and increased perspiration, were recorded during the examination. The analysis and evaluation of all polygraphs revealed that the subjects were deceptive to the relevant issues. Through all these psychological examinations which are being conducted on those subjects revealed that their aim is to induce terror and psychic fear through the violent victimization and destruction of non-combatant targets. The terrorist groups and organizations screen out emotionally unstable individuals and they represent a security risk. They are all pessimistic towards their life and highly sensitive towards their religion and jihad. They do not show any feeling of remorse after mercilessly committing murders or mass killings and other tumultuous acts. Now, the staircase to join the terrorist group is quite a strange process which involves the following steps. First one is motivation and joining to the terrorist group, like the modus operandi of the terrorist group, how they recruit the young youth in their group. Interestingly, poverty and unemployment is not the only factor attributed to join terrorism, but unfortunately, youth with proper educational background and from middle class families are also enticed toward this credit phenomenon. Most of the youth have either been self-motivated by watching the radical propaganda material on the internet and have been so brainwashed that they have left their jobs and decided to take up the path of terrorism. Another critical issue is the use of social networking sites and the internet-related activities that are fueling the terrorism. The overground workers of the terrorist groups motivate the local youth to follow the right preaching of their religion. There are different sessions of training like motivating the youth, then giving them weapon and technical training. Then after the highly motivated youth are given rigorous training and respectively sent to various cities of the country to perform the terrorist attacks. The training imparted to the young terrorists involved. The training camp consists of group of people around the age of 20 to 25 years who are randomly selected. They are given training on physical endurance, weapon handling, night march, GPS handling, and handling arms and ammunition. After completing this basic training, they join another level under the banner of specific terrorist groups. There they are imparted training with specialization in GPS handling, map reading, wireless operating, compass reading, and deep knowledge about the use of Google Earth application. They are then selected for the operational group to carry out attacks in various places of India. They are also given the code to contact with other group persons who are already present in India. The operational group is also provided with arms and ammunition and other equipments like wire cutter, telescope, night vision device, knives, and mobile handsets. Their main is to attempt the Fidayeen attack. The terrorists are directly directed by their leaders for Fidayeen attack on civilians, security personnel, which lead to large number of casualties and killings. These attacks include surprise and shock as essential elements and are bound to cause greater damage. The conclusion can be drawn from their psychological examination. Like these terrorist groups are constantly evolving their tactics to keep one pace ahead of the security and intelligence agencies and to avoid detection by them. They have also enhanced the use of cyberspace and satellite phones for communication, propaganda, and online recruitment. Social networking sites and online messaging tools are being used for coded communication. New recruitment patterns of some groups included recruiting the suicide commandos, female and child terrorists, and the scientists who are capable of developing weapons of mass destruction. These terrorists have refined their tactical skills and the attacks are well calibrated and involve a careful selection of targets and meticulous planning over a long period before actually executing the attacks. The understanding of terrorism and psychological implication are essential to comprehend psychological and motivating surrounding the root of terrorism in order to implement policies and counter terrorism prevention strategies. There is a need to deconstruct the concept of terrorism and to understand how the choice of violence by these terrorists can be explained by their psychology. The psychology of terrorists relies on the fact how youth choose to act of terrorism as a way to express their ideology, their opinion, and their struggle. The psychology of terrorism discusses the psychological variables that underlie the terrorism phenomenon and the consequences of the terrorist act on the societies. So basically the aim of this presentation is that various psychological tests are conducted on these type of personalities to understand how they are promoting the terrorism. So better we should stand united against the terrorism to fight against the crime. Thank you.